Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, I'm going to show you how to make simple websites using Keynote. So Keynote has the option to export to HTML to create a website from a presentation. Now you can't do too much with it. You can't create complex websites, but you can create very simple ones, and a lot of times that's exactly what's needed. So let's look at an example here. I've just started a new document. I'm going to choose one of the preset templates here, just something that's going to be easy for me to demonstrate. I'm going to choose this one right here, and we're going to build a very simple website using this template. So we're going to create a 5-page website for a simple fictional store here. I'm going to select the first slide that it puts in there. I'm going to select format over here and change the master so it's something that would make sense for a website. So let's just go with the default artwork here just to make things quick, and say we're doing a pottery store. So we'll do my store here. I'm going to get rid of this text here and use a space down here for what you would expect on a website, which would be some buttons. So we're going to use shape tool here to create some buttons. I'm going to just create a simple square here, and I'm going to create a button like this, and then I'm going to put some text in it. So like the first thing we might want to do is a button for that, our story. And then we're going to want to have a series of buttons on the bottom. So I'm going to option drag to duplicate this button 4 times here. And then I'm going to select all 4. I'm actually going to space these out so the ends, that looks about right. I'm going to make sure they're distributed nicely. I'm going to select arrange here on the right, distribute them horizontally. And they already are pretty well distributed. So we've now got 4 buttons. Let's do like about us, and maybe you would have directions or a location button, and maybe one for hours. So these would go to 4 different pages on the same website. And then of course you would put a picture in here that's your picture, but we're just going to pretend we're doing a pottery store and this happens to be our picture. So here we already have the first page of our website. So let's create 4 other pages. So let's say the first one is going to be our story. Let's create one that's got an image on the side, and we'll then put some fake text here. I can turn off the bullets so we have some plain text. And then we'll create another slide here, and I'm going to create 4 of them and put them in place. So now I've got 4 different pages here to match the 4 buttons. So how do I link these together? Because right now it's a presentation. If I'm showing this slide, I click anywhere and it simply just goes to the next slide. So what I want to do is I want to link these buttons to the individual pages. If I control click or use 2 fingers on a trackpad, I can add a link to this, and I say I want it to go to a slide and give it a specific slide I want it to go to. So I want to do slide 2 for this, and you can see now it shows that there's a link there, and I could do that for all of these, linking to the proper slide. Now when I run this presentation, I'll be able to mouse over any of these, and you can see each one acts like a button, and I can jump to a specific slide on here. The next thing we need is a way to get back. So for that I'm going to take one of these buttons here, because I want it to be the same kind of button, and I want to copy it and then paste it. So Command C, Command V, and I'm going to put it here on this page. I'm going to change the text to back, and I'm going to control click it again and edit the link and have it go to the first slide. And now that I've got that back button there, I can copy it and then paste it onto all the other pages of the website. Put it in the appropriate spot anywhere I want. So now when I run, I can use the back button to go to that first page from any of these pages. The next thing I want to do is I'm going to change something about this presentation. I'm going to go to the document settings here, change the presentation type to links only. So that means it won't automatically advance to the next slide when I click on a slide. It will only advance to another slide clicking one of these links. So it behaves just like a website. Now that I've got it working the way I want, I simply go to File and then Export, and I can choose HTML as the export type, and I'm going to export it as a series of files in a folder. So now here in the Finder, this is what I've got. I've got a folder where I've put all this stuff, and it has an index.html file, which is the a main page for a website, and it has a folder full of assets that has all the rest of the stuff, the graphics and everything. If I were to double click on this, it will launch Safari and I can view the website as HTML, not as a Keynote presentation any longer. So as you can see, this is running in my web browser, but it's still just files on my drive here. And it works. I can view the photos in there. I can click on any of the links and go back and find out all this information that I've put on the website. And it's very easily done. And now all I need to do if I wanted to actually put this on the website is get a host and upload that index.html and that assets folder to that web host. And any just about any web host that lets you upload raw files will do. And you've created a website. And you can easily alter this presentation as many times as you like and simply replace all the files. So you can update your hours and your information and all of that very quickly and easily without needing a web designer. So if your needs are for a simple website, this could be the way to make it. And one last thing I want to point out. Suppose you want to change this button here to a contact button. You can do that, and in links here, instead of doing slide, you can do email, put your email address and a subject in here, and somebody can click on the link and send you an email. You could also change it to web page where you can have them go to a contact form, but say for the directions button, you can have them go to a link to Google Maps. You've copied a link that shows your location on Google Maps. You can place that in there. Or you can link out to another site, like say if you have an eBay store or Amazon front store, you can go and put that link in here. So there's a lot you can do. You don't just have to store information. You can actually make the site somewhat functional.